Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see the difference between container and container fluid class in Bootstrap. In previous videos we already see the introduction to Bootstrap, then how to access the Bootstrap into HTML web pages, how to create a simple web design, a simple web page. All these concepts are already cover in our channel, so links are provided in the description box. Do check it out. And in this video we can see container and container fluid class. So without any further ado, let's quickly get started. So this is the basic HTML page. We already see how to create it, we can see here is the document type, which is HTML. Then our root element, which is HTML element. In that HTML element we provide a head section. In that we add Bootstrap links, we access the Bootstrap through CDN. And then here is the title, this is the title page, and our head section will be completed. After that, here is a body part, and in this body element we can provide h1 tag, then paragraph tag, and this is our HTML, basic HTML page in which we can access the Bootstrap through CDN links. So here I would add container and container fluid class. So we can see how to add the container class and container fluid class. What is the difference between container class, container fluid class? So look at here. Container class means it will be a fixed size. Okay, when you use the container class to create a web pages, then that web page will be created as a fixed size. Your container fluid class, it will be adjustable, or it will be created full size of your screen resolution. So this is the difference between container and container fluid. We can see with example. So here, how to add the container class? You can see here. We have to add the class. So we have to provide a division tag, div tag. So in this tag, we can add the container. So here, in this, we provide a class attribute. And which class we have to add it? Which will be container class. So here we can add the container class, and in this container class, if you want to add some content, then provide here. So I will just copy these two lines and paste here. And this is our container class. So I just save this program. I delete these two lines because it will be added into the container class. Save just this program and run this program. For run the program, we open the file location. And then here, we select our file hi.html. And then simply right click, and once you right click, then you have to, there are multiple options. Here is the option open with, so I open with Google Chrome. So here you can see this is our output, and you can see this is the fixed size. Okay, you cannot shift here or here. You have to provide a specific size of web page, and this is our outcome of container class. And now we can simply see the container fluid class, and after that we can see the difference between container and container fluid class. So come back to our program, and I simply copy this container class and paste. And here you can see in between div tag, I provide a class attribute, and for that class attribute I mention here which class, container fluid class. And for that I also print here only hi, not a hello world. And paragraph will be same, and our div tag will be close. And once I save this program and refresh our web page, then let's see what happened. You can see this is the first outcome of our container class, and this is the outcome of our container fluid class. So you can see your container class is in a fixed size middle of the page, okay, and your container fluid class, it will be adjustable as per your screen resolution. It will be a full screen, just like a full screen content will be shown by using a container fluid class. And once you minimize and maximize the screen resolution, then you can see it will be adjust container as well as container fluid class will be adjust as per your screen resolution. I minimize the screen, then you can see what happened. And once I maximize the screen, let's see what happened. The container class and container fluid class will be adjust as per your screen resolution. And this is for your laptop screen, but now I will test this for mobile screen. So I click on inspect button. Simply right click on page and then click on inspect button, and here you can see laptop and mobile option here. So I have checked this web page on a mobile format. So you can see this is the mobile section, and once you minimize the mobile screen, then what happened? Let's see, as per your mobile screen, the font size and all the things are adjustable, and the width and the web page size also adjustable. But your container class is of fixed size, it will not occupy the whole screen, but your container fluid class will be occupy whole screen. It will be adjustable, it will be full screen, it will be occupy all the XYZ axis, okay, but container fluid is of fixed size, it will be leave the margins X and Y axis, but your container fluid does not leave any margins. So this is the difference between container and container fluid class. Mostly your container fluid class is used to create a responsive web pages, because there is no need to use any, if you want to, there is no need to provide any margins, then you can use container fluid class. Or if you do not require the fixed size web page, it if it will be vary as per your screen, if you accept that, then you can use the container fluid class. And this is the difference between container and container fluid class. I hope you understood with practically what is the difference between container and container fluid class. If this video is a little bit helpful for you, please do like to this video, also share with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do subscribe. Also hit the bell icon for such new videos, because whenever I upload new videos or whenever I post any content on my video channel, then you never miss any updates from my side. And for watching this video, thank you so much, friends. Stay tuned for next video.